Now at 11, a Salem nurse on leave tonight after downplaying protective COVID measures in a viral TikTok video. And later, keeping furry family members fed, the Oregon Humane Society gets ready for a pet food bank. But first, COVID cases hit a new high in Oregon, and workplace outbreaks spark new emergency protections for workers. Your news starts right now.
This is KGW News at 11.
Hello, and thanks for staying up with us. I'm Brittany Folgers. Oregon reports another daily record for COVID-19 cases. 1,669 new cases reported today. That brings the state total to more than 72,000. The Oregon Health Authority also reports 11 more people have died. And it's important to note here, the state says today's case count is higher because of delays in reporting from Thanksgiving. It was expectedly lower yesterday for that same reason. Now, all of this comes as hospitalizations for COVID-19 rise. The number of hospitalized COVID-19 patients across Oregon rose to 529. That's 8 more than yesterday. There are 106 COVID-19 patients in the ICU. That's 9 fewer than yesterday. And when you dig into the numbers, you see a sizable amount of cases come from workplace outbreaks. As a result, Oregon OSHA has new emergency rules. Galen Etlin looks at the hotspots.
We need to have rules in place that ensure that we're not in this mess again.
Graham Traynor is president of Oregon Statewide Federation of Labor Unions. His group advocates for workers' rights. He says 1 in 6 Oregonians have gotten COVID-19 from a workplace outbreak. This chart shows some of the biggest active workplace outbreaks in the last week of November. Most are within prisons, with more than 1,200 cases among the top three. Others include distribution centers like Amazon in Troutdale at 97 cases, Fred Meyer in Clackamas at 88, and Walmart in Hermiston at 79. Food processing plants, too, like the Lamb Weston Potato Facility at 88 cases. So now, Oregon OSHA has new rules in place.
Whether they're a Department of Corrections worker or a warehouse worker or a food processing worker, that they have industry-specific and workplace-specific plans that can keep them safe on the job.
Employers must notify workers about possible exposure within 24 hours and provide training for spread prevention. They must also take input from employees.
No one knows their workplace and their job better than the worker doing it.
Safer ventilation is also required in places where workers cannot be remote. Traynor says Oregon is taking the right step without federal help, but that more can be done for workers on the front lines.
Is to treat them like the heroes that we like to call them. That also includes paying them for the risks that they bear when they go to work.
I'm Galen Etlin for KGW News.
Well, get this. A Salem Health nurse is on administrative leave over a now viral TikTok video. In it, she states she does not wear a mask in public away from work. She also says she travels and lets her kids have play dates. The original TikTok from user LoveIsKind05 was deleted along with the account. But a duet version with another person reacting to the video has gone viral. The nurse has not been identified, but her apparent employer, Salem Health, released a statement saying she has been placed on administrative leave pending an investigation. The statement goes on to say, quote, "We also want to assure you that this one careless statement does not reflect the position of Salem Health or the hardworking and dedicated caregivers who work here. Salem Health believes we all need to do our part to protect the vulnerable and stop the rapid spread of COVID-19. A haven for the homeless in downtown Portland is closed tonight because of COVID. Two staff members and 4 residents at Union Gospel Mission tested positive. The mission offers a variety of services, including daily meals. A part-time staffer tested positive Tuesday. That led to additional tests. A handful of people were positive on Thursday. Residents and staff are quarantined. The mission is thinking of ways to still provide their much-needed services.
The main thing that we're trying to adjust is how to maybe continue to provide some meals for people who are experiencing homelessness in Old Town Portland without having to do it out of the building that we've closed. So we're working with some staff and volunteers who have not been exposed and who could maybe provide us with some to-go meals that we could still distribute downtown.
The Union Gospel Mission is also temporarily closing its Tigard thrift shop. All residents and staff were tested Friday, and those results are expected in the next couple of days. The Oregon Humane Society is providing pandemic help to pet owners, giving out free food next week. Art Edwards joins us now with that and an update on adoptions. Hey, Art.
Hey there. You know what? As challenging as things might be right now, the Oregon Humane Society is really looking to help, whether it's providing pet food or adoptions. They figured out a way to keep serving the community during the pandemic.
Giving Tuesday is on Tuesday, and we thought of no better way to help pet owners in our community than by hosting a pet food bank to provide free food for pet owners in the community and for those who need it.
The Pet Food Bank will operate December 2nd and 3rd, just north of the Humane Society's main shelter. It's not the first time the Oregon Humane Society has done this in 2020. In June, they hosted a pet food bank in Portland, and before that, they went statewide.
During the month of April, we went to every single county in Oregon and delivered about 60,000 pounds worth of food.
And during the pandemic, they've continued to do pet adoptions. They've had to figure out a creative way to do that safely.
Since March, we've been doing adoptions by appointment. So the bulk of the work is done over the phone and online. So folks go to our website at OregonHumane.org. They see an animal they're interested in. They can submit a questionnaire. Our adoption counselors will talk to them on the phone about that pet's specific need. We have a contactless option where we basically just meet the person curbside and deliver that pet.
They also help pets impacted by natural disasters, taking in dogs and cats from California after the wildfires and Louisiana after hurricanes. The Oregon Humane Society is doing anything it can to help.
We're committed to doing everything we can to help us all get through this together and keep those pets in those homes, keep those relationships strong with their animals.
Now, if you'd like to learn more about the Pet Food Bank or adopting a pet from the Humane Society, you can go to the Oregon Humane Society website at OregonHumane.org.
Well, that's great. Thanks so much, Art.